Over 68% of all cardiac arrests in the United States occur in the home. How can you be prepared when a crisis happens? Watch this video to find out. PennCare presents the Philips HeartStart Home AED, an automated external defibrillator designed for home operation by an untrained or minimally trained user and available without a prescription. In this video, we'll be discussing how to operate the HeartStart Home AED, when to use it, and how to properly care for the unit in order to keep it ready for use. The HeartStart Home AED is easy to set up, with no medical training required to operate the device. It supplies voice prompts and CPR coaching to guide users through the emergency treatment of sudden cardiac arrest. At just 3.3 pounds, the device is light enough to be deployed quickly by almost anybody and is suitable for treatment of cardiac arrest in victims of any age, including adults, children, and even infants. The HeartStart Home AED uses Philips' patented quick shock technology to minimize chest compression interruptions, and the device's smart pads sense application to the patient's skin to intuitively align with the response process. A shock is typically delivered just 8 seconds after CPR. To set up the HeartStart Home AED for the first time, first, remove it from its packaging, then take it out of the red case and pull out the red tab to start the automatic battery self-test. A voice from the HeartStart Home AED will instruct you to press the flashing orange shock button. Don't worry, no shock will be given during the self-test. After about a minute, the test will conclude, the device will turn off, and the green ready light will start blinking. If you didn't hear a voice during the self-test, or if the device tells you the shock button was not verified when you pressed it, or if the green ready light is not blinking at the end of the test, call 1-866-333-4246 for Philips customer support. Your HeartStart Home AED comes with a short training video that you should watch and review once a year. Review the quick reference guide that came with the device, as it contains additional information for users of the HeartStart Home AED who are hearing impaired. Keep the quick reference guide and the owner's manual in the carry case with the device. On the back of the carrying case, there is a call 911 card. On the back of that card, write your name and address. Next, decide where to keep your HeartStart Home AED. Convenient areas to store it are often the family room, kitchen, or living room. It should be in a place where you can easily see and hear it, so you can check that the green ready light is blinking, or hear alert sounds if there's a problem with the device. If someone is suffering from sudden cardiac arrest, they will not be breathing normally and will not respond when touched or shaken. If there is more than one bystander available, have someone call emergency services while you set up the HeartStart Home AED. If nobody else is available, call emergency services. Then get the HeartStart Home AED. Unzip the storage case and lay it flat. Activate the Philips HeartStart Home AED by pulling on the green handle and set the cover aside. Voice prompts will begin to guide you through the defibrillation process. Users are then directed to remove all clothing from the victim's chest. Pull the tab at the top of the smart pads cartridge to remove the seal and remove the two pads from the cartridge. The liner from the pad must be removed, exposing the adhesive surface. Place the first pad on the victim's upper right chest and place the second pad on the victim's left side, wrapping around the ribs. Press the pads firmly into the skin so that they make good contact. Be sure to note any lumps or surgical scars on the victim's chest. These could be indicators of an implanted defibrillator or pacemaker. Avoid placing the pads over these areas. The HeartStart Home AED will start analyzing the victim's heart rhythm after the pads are attached. The device's caution light will begin flashing as it studies the victim's heart rhythm, and nobody should be touching the victim during this time. If a shock is required, the device will instruct you to press the flashing orange shock button. Before pressing the shock button, make sure nobody is touching the victim. After pressing the shock button, the device will confirm that a shock has been applied and that it is once again safe to touch the victim. The HeartStart Home AED will then analyze the heart rhythm once more and determine if CPR should be administered. If CPR instruction is needed, the user can press the flashing blue I button to receive coaching. If the HeartStart Home AED determines a shock is not needed, the device will alert the user that it's safe to touch the victim and begin CPR if necessary. If the victim is moving or has regained consciousness, then obey local safety protocols until emergency medical services arrive. For treatment of an infant or child victim, first begin CPR while an available person calls emergency services. If nobody else is available, perform CPR for 1 to 2 minutes before retrieving the HeartStart Home AED, unless you witness the child's collapse. Remove all clothing from the child's torso, because the pads will be placed on the child's chest and back. Place one pad on the center of the chest and the other pad in the center of the back. The HeartStart Home AED will automatically reduce the charge to an appropriate level for an infant or child victim. An infant-child CPR coaching can be provided from the device if needed. When emergency medical personnel arrive, you should explain to them what happened as clearly as possible. Inform them that if they hold down the blue I button, the device will report how long ago it was activated and how many shocks were delivered. After the victim's care has been transferred to emergency medical services, you can turn off the HeartStart Home AED by holding down the green on-off button for 1 second. There are certain situations where the HeartStart Home AED or any automated external defibrillator should never be used. If the victim is in water or excessively wet or sweaty, the device should not be used. It should never be operated around oxygen containers or other combustible materials, and you should never attempt to use the HeartStart Home AED on yourself. The HeartStart Home AED is conveniently available without a prescription. The package includes the defibrillator, a lithium battery pack, an adult smart pads cartridge, training video, quick reference guide, and an envelope containing the owner's manual and other useful information. Training pads can also be installed in the device that disable the unit's ability to deploy a shock so that users can safely practice using the device. The HeartStart Home AED performs daily self-evaluations of all systems, including the battery, and also tests itself to confirm that the pads are installed properly. A blinking green ready light lets a potential user know that the unit is ready. After using the HeartStart Home AED, check the outside of the unit for damage or dirt. If necessary, clean it with a soft, damp cloth and soapy water. Ammonia-based cleaners can also be used, or a mixture of 2 tablespoons of chlorine bleach diluted in a quart of water. Never use rubbing alcohol, acetone-based, or enzymatic cleaners to clean the HeartStart Home AED. Do not submerge the unit in any liquids or allow liquids to spill onto it. Sterilizing the HeartStart Home AED or any of its components is not necessary. Philips smart pads are single-use only and need to be replaced after deployment. To install new pads, use the latch on the top of the unit and slide it aside. This will release the cartridge lock and allow the spent cartridge to be removed. Open a new SmartPads cartridge and slide it into the cartridge recess. When the cartridge is properly placed, there will be an audible click. Ensure the green pull handle is all the way down. Then, record the replacement of the cartridge in the maintenance tag. The HeartStart Home AED stores data automatically for 30 days following its last use and holds information such as ECG recordings for 15 minutes after attachment of the smart pads, the device's status during the incident, the device's rhythm analysis decisions for the duration of the incident, and the elapsed time associated with all of these events. Removing the battery erases all of the data from the HeartStart Home AED's last use. You should always establish a schedule for performing periodic checks to the HeartStart Home AED. Don't store the device without a smart pads cartridge installed. First, make sure that the green ready light is blinking. Check any spare accessories for damage, and replace any that have expired. Inspect the body of the unit for cracks or damage, and if damage is present, contact Philips Technical Support for assistance. You should record all maintenance checks in the included maintenance log. It is recommended to have a spare battery and spare smart pads with the HeartStart Home AED, and these can be purchased separately. Child-infant smart pads are strongly encouraged if the unit will be used on a child victim. Other suggested accessories include scissors for cutting through clothing, disposable gloves to protect the user, a disposable razor for removing chest hair if the pads cannot make good contact, a mask or face shield to protect the user, and a towel or wipes to dry the skin for good pad contact. These items are available separately in a Philips Fast Response Kit. The HeartStart Home AED's ease of use makes it the best choice for a home defibrillator. Philips Smart Analysis and CPR coaching are there to guide you through the stress of a sudden cardiac situation, and Philips' patented quick shock technology ensures that victims receive the highest peak current in the first shock. For more information about the Philips HeartStart Home AED or other products from the Philips family, contact PennCare, your trusted leader for medical supplies and equipment. Please remember to give us a like, leave a comment, and subscribe to our YouTube channel.